There are clinicians involved in the writing and publication of the DSM criteria on personality disorders who believe this diagnosis should not exist. So in this video, we'll take a brief look at why it does, this controversial psychiatric condition, narcissistic personality disorder. To meet a formal diagnosis of NPD, a person must display greater than or equal to 5 of the following. 1. Has an over-the-top feeling of self-importance. 2. Believes they are special and unique and that they should only associate with other such special or high-status people. 3. Holds a sense of entitlement, expecting unreasonably favourable treatment. 4. Obsessed with fantasies and dreams of power, unlimited success, or ideal love. 5. Needs more and more admiration. 6. Exploits people. 7. Lacks emotional empathy. 8. Often envious of others. And 9. Displays arrogant and haughty behaviour. Looking at these criteria, have a think why the disorder might be controversial. There are parts to it that are quite vague and also quite universal to the spectrum of normal human nature. When this is the case, we know there'll be inappropriate self-diagnosis gone wild out in the community. One clinician suggests that more people self-diagnose with NPD than any other condition. It was first recognized in the 1980 edition of the DSM, and was initially to be removed from the 2013 edition, the 5th. But following feedback from some other clinicians, it was reinstated. Why do you reckon that would have been? Because at the end of the day, the diagnosis was only invented to help clinicians help patients. If a person with the characteristics of NPD experience a crisis of mental health, treatment and education regarding the condition can help them to improve their lives. Living with NPD may not always seem subjectively hard, but just as with any mental illness, diagnosis can be helpful to the extent that it brings about self-awareness. No one should live with their diagnosis as a label forever. Life's more malleable than that, but for a person with NPD, it might be the catalyst that allows them to relearn interpersonal relationships, making them hurt future partners less, and in turn, making their own lives better. As with many mental health diagnoses, the way a person looks at the diagnosis can change how helpful it is. And while self-diagnosis is unfortunately common, we have to remember that the qualities represented in the diagnosis of NPD are also unfortunately common. Thanks for watching, and we will see you next time.